ESPN's coverage of the Stanley Cup Finals is brought to you by the new Dodge. We're thinking ahead. And by new Miller beer, the brand new beer from Miller with big flavor that goes down easy.
Welcome back, everybody. A beautiful day here in Denver. Now folks gathered around here and in Miami and where you happen to be to see game two as the Avalanche have a chance to go up 2-0 as they came away with a 3-1 win in game one. A chance to go 2-0 playing here at home before a crowd that you might say has gone a little hockey crazy. Niedermeyer out, Patrick Wise in, then of course for the Avalanche, John Van Beesbrouck will be at the other end. Don Koharski, our referee tonight, is sixth Stanley Cup final series. And we're underway. Set back in around the near sideboards. No changes in the lineup from game one. Swung around to Mellenby on the far side. Mellenby of the Panthers checked off the puck along the boards. It was freed up there. Sent back in. Uwe Krupp comes back to get it. Krupp spins it off the near sideboards to center. Kartner out to get it. The Avalanche wanting to come out with a stronger start than they had in the first game of the finals. They felt they just did not get a good jump.
And that should be easy for them after that 5-6 day layoff that they had coming into game one. It is so hard to get ready. They weathered the storm and won the game. That's what's important for them.
Came back from behind to do it, of course. Taken back in the corner by Martin Straka. Straka up the near side for Niedermeyer. Niedermeyer paid for it. Hit by foot. Shot in Clem. That was deflected wide by Yell in front. Comes back to Gusarov. His shot. That's through a screen but wide on Van Beesbrouck. Puck on the near side. Here at least in the first couple of shifts it certainly looks as though the Avalanche has got an extra step compared to game one. It'll be taken back deep in the zone by Adam Foote. Swung it out through the middle for Clem. Puck checked away. Back in on Patrick Waugh. Gusarov on the far side. Both teams changing it up here. Rolled back along the blue line. Ed Marsh will send that one in up wide. It's dumped there into the corner. Van Beesbrouck swung around the near side. Warner couldn't get it. Comes to Lowry on the near boards. Lowry sent it out through the middle. Jammed up there. Barnes trying to hold it in on the far side. Couldn't do it. Forsberg sent it up for Ed Marsh. It went behind him instead. Off the near side at the red line. Lowry got it in for Barnes. Barnes back for Lowry. Dropped it. Barnes sends it wide side. And Gordon Murphy decided not to step up to try and get it. Cleared out. Peter Forsberg was there. Forsberg got it out of the zone. Well, we start out with a real good pace here in this game. Sent back out by Foote, taken there. Jovanovski comes back to get it. Set it off the near side, boards it into the zone on the left. Lindsay. Lindsay looking, tried to center. Lost right back to him. Lindsay goes back on top. Jovanovski's shot. That's deflected out deep on him. Chance for a 2-on-1. Breaks Stefan Yell. Yell coming, trying to center. Broken up by Laws. Would have been a 2-on-1, but Paul Laws got there and broke up that pass.
What a great defensive play. Reichel was wide open.
Shot in, deflected. Ozelich had the opportunity. Yell comes back to get it. Centering pass bounced in front of Yell, in front on the center. Good chance. Keane dumped it out in front for Yell. Uwe Krupp comes back. The Avalanche with the early step. Here's Mike Keane. Team's changing. Keane will give it a high flip into the corner. Sacking out. Sacking in the corner left at Reichel and the big hit with Kartner over there. Knocked down by Young. Could not hold it in the zone. Cleared back out by Mike Huff. Uwe Krupp comes back to get it. Well, you'd expect a strong pace early on in the game, and that's exactly what we've got here in the first period of this one. No call there. Fans wanted one. Won't get it on the look-like call down. Robert Svala was there to pick up the loose puck. Cleared back into the middle. Deeper into the zone. Ozelinch and Lefebvre. Goes around Lefebvre to Ricci and cleared up. First icing call will be coming here on the touch by Svala. Great to have you with us. Our exclusive coverage here on ESPN of game two of the Stanley Cup Finals. We lined up this herd of deer and buffalo just for this shot. We spare no expense.
Darren Payne was out there all day herding them.
Well, actually, we sent John Davidson out there. He didn't have anything to do today, so he said, J.D., go out there and round up a few for us, will you? Ricci ready to take the faceoff here. Coming to the left of Patrick Waugh. Brian Skrudland waiting. Ricci arguing with Kevin Collins, the linesman. Collins in his 19th year in the National Hockey League as a linesman. Shot deflected in front. Sakic picks it up and strikes it out. Sakic held without a point in the last game. That's only happened in two playoff games this year. That deflects up over and a souvenir off the stick of Joe Sakic. Our netminders tonight, take a look at John Van Beesbrouck, who gave up three in a 3:48 span of the second period, but big numbers.
He said about the Colorado Avalanche after game one. He said, forget about the tape. He said, Colorado, when they buzz, they really buzz hard, harder than any team that they have faced so far in the playoffs. Patrick Roy at the other end seems to be having more fun. He has admitted that round one was the most pressure-filled round for him because he was expected to win in the playoffs, and he's been here before. I mean, he seems to be really at peace with himself and very confident right now. Van Beesbrouck is too, for that matter. That's why this series could be one of the greatest goaltending duels in the history of the Stanley Cup Finals.
You got two real good ones, real good veterans. Mellenby's pass knocked down. Law had interesting comments yesterday saying, "I feel so free playing here in this franchise." He said, "It's not a negative on Montreal, but there we went by the book, and we were told not to generate publicity and not to talk to the press all the time, and we were always thinking about what we couldn't do rather than what we could do." And here he says, they just say, "Be yourself." So that's what he's doing. Ozolich played it behind the net. Plus, when you play it in more games now than any other netminder in the playoffs, it's a lot easier to be yourself here in the Stanley Cup Finals. Chipped off on the near side boards. Straka takes it back. Both teams changing it up on the fly. We're heading up and down the ice in a hurry here in this game, but not a lot of chances. The Avalanche have had one shot. That's the only shot of the game. Detmar's cutting, deflected. Score!
To get a bounce early. This is the time of year where a bounce can be the difference. And Peter Forsberg was clearly trying to hit Adam Detmars. But here it is. Look, two players facing him. Both defenders were facing Peter Forsberg. Nobody was looking at Detmars behind, but it didn't matter. It caromed off a couple of skates. Rhett Warner went down. You know what? Peter Forsberg got his own rebound. What a great second effort by Peter Forsberg to give the Avalanche a 1-0 lead. He was clearly passing to Detmars. Good defensive play by Warner. Nothing he could do about Forsberg's second effort.
Great second effort to reach in. And the Avalanche take the 1-0 lead. They, of course, fell behind the Panthers. 1-0 in the first period of game one. Dumped off for Fitzgerald. Backhand run. Wah! Garpenlund was celebrating, but Wah made the save. Fitzgerald set up Johan Garpenlund, and he tipped it in. And Wah was there and knocked it down. Keane in the corner. Kartner puts the shot on him, picked up by Yell. Sends it around to the near side. Lindsay in his own end. Saw the hit coming, tried to protect the puck, lost it to Detmars. The Avalanche definitely have the early extra step here in this first period. It is what they wanted to come out doing, and they're doing it. Kartner battling in the corner there. Couldn't freeze it up, wrapped around high, not out of the zone. Jammed right back in on the far side as Gusarov was over there. Chipped away. They're not able to get the rush going in. Ewing Krupp was there. Detmars. Detmars fakes one. Got around Jovanovski, but the puck was left behind him. Jovanovski will bring it out the other way. Intercepted at center. Boy, they are playing some tough D. Kaminsky moving in alone. Kaminsky, forehand side, backhand side, deflected by Van Beesbrouck.
Gary, it's the first time in the playoffs I've seen Eddie Jovanovski's age really show through. He put one into a set of shin pads, his first shift of the game, and this shift, he came up the center, tried to dump it in and misfired, and that's how Colorado went the other way. Be interesting to see if Eddie Joe continues to get ice time.
Look at this. Forsberg once, twice, shot, save Van Beesbrouck. Peter Forsberg has come out like a house of fire. Penalty behind the play coming up on Colorado. Wait for the touch by the Avalanche. Lafave going back to get it. And there's the whistle. A penalty and a power play coming for the Panthers.
Peter Forsberg has said that his confidence isn't what it should be. Guess what? He may have taken a great giant step towards getting it all back. I'll tell you, in the first goal of the game, he made a terrific second effort play. And in his last shift, he looks like he's ready to go. I mean, his puck handling is his confidence. If he handles the puck well, you can tell he's all over his confidence. This looked pretty good to me. John Van Beesbrouck, though, great positioning. Peter Forsberg tried to go high to the short side, nothing there. Moments earlier, Patrick Roy, excellent save in close. The Panthers tried to counter. They only got one shot at it. That's going to be a key as well. Can the Panthers generate rebound chances against Patrick Roy?
The goal came at 4:11. Forsberg first in this series, his eighth of the playoffs, unassisted. Adam Detmars draws the roughing call at the 5:53 mark. Neither of these teams able to convert on the power play in the first game. Colorado went 0-for-8, while the Panthers went 0-for-5.
Only five shots in their five power plays in game one for the Panthers. They need this. Mind you, Colorado's not going to win this game in the first period. The Panthers bend, they seldom break.
Power play opportunity, Svejla. Svejla looking for Mellenby in front. Svejla brings it in. His shot, wide, trying to find it, does. Svejla had Niedermeyer blocking for him in front. He had a pretty good run.
Well, that's what the Avalanche did in game one. They find the picks. In other words, the pick doesn't come and find you. You try to find it, the screens and the picks, and move to it. Stephan Yell on the faceoff, and you can see that Florida was trying to tie guys up. When Yell went down, Svejla was able to get around. There's 26. Stephan Yell tried to get back in the play, but he fell down, and Svejla really smartly went wide and then in front.
Patrick Waugh, winner of two Conn Smythe Awards, of course, with Montreal. Got a shot at another one, although certainly Joe Sakic at this point. Maybe a bit ahead of him in that department, but a long way to go before that decision is made.
John Van Beesbrook's right there.
Svejla will start it up on the power play. The Avalanche leading it 1-0. Martin Straka near side gets by Foot. Straka in himself, centering pass deflected. Tried to get it in front to Mellenby. Bounced off skates and cleared out by Yell. The shots are 4-2 in favor of the Avalanche. Colorado's taken the early 1-0 lead. First power play of the game. Going here to the Florida Panthers. Chipped away at center to Straka. Centered into Mellenby. Mellenby could not control. In the corner with it. Clem lost it. Centered in front. Shot deflected off Huey Krupp. Good chance for Gord Murphy, but he hit Krupp with a shot. Put back in the zone onside. Shot that one. Rips wide by Hanna. Held up with the far wing. Shot by Svejla. Partially blocked. Lefebvre clears it the length of the ice.
Couple of gambles by the Avalanche. They got away with it. Huey Krupp pitched up on the boards in his own zone. Missed the puck. Another chance for the Panthers.
Power play down to 40 seconds left on it here. Lowry has come out on this power play unit. There's Ray Sheppard as a hit off his skates in the zone offside. Sheppard was right along the blue line. Now Adam Foote gets into it along the near side boards with Dave Lowry. Still 33 seconds left on the Florida power play. Our new Dodge intermission report upcoming at the end of this first period. We'll take a look at the so-called muckers of the game. They may not score a lot before they vital to a team's success. Barry Melrose with the analysis of our first period, and we'll have reports from each of the locker rooms all coming up in our new Dodge intermission report.
Now, I really expect the Panthers to have a good hockey game. It really has been Avalanche in the early going, but my theory is this: you never embarrass proud, intelligent athletes. There was a column written here in a newspaper yesterday that trashed the Panthers' style. And you know what? They don't deserve it. That's like saying that Joe Frazier didn't warrant his championship belt as much as Muhammad Ali because he wasn't as pretty. They bled to get here. You got to pay the price to get here. So I think this team is embarrassed. I really expect them to really play an inspired game.
Well, they had the Denver Post, the newspaper that had the column, in each of the locker stalls yesterday for the players to read and see what was said. He's going to use that as part of a psychological effort to pump these guys even further.
And Gary, the Avalanche players actually told me this morning that they expected Florida to come out with jump, and they were sorry that the column was written.
Yeah.
You know, it didn't come from them.
Tell you, the papers here after game one. Look at this. This is the front page of the Post. You think they aren't a little hockey crazy out here? The Rocky Mountain News changed the name of their paper.
At least for a couple of weeks.
At least for a couple of weeks. Off the faceoff, sent back in the zone. 10 left in the power play for the Panthers. Gusarov's got it in the corner. Gusarov trying to clear it up near side, not up. Dobrovsky's shot deflected in front again by Foot. Turned around. Shot. Score! They tied it up! Stu Barnes! A power play goal. 1-1.
The man that had to do it, and the special team that had to do it. The power play, and Stu Barnes, smart player. I mean, there was a scrum for the puck, and the goal scorers hang to the side of the pack. Forget about getting involved in trying to pick the puck out. Wait, hope that it comes your way. And when it came to Stu Barnes, how many high goals has he scored in the playoffs? Every time I see a replay, if we didn't do the game, Gary, we've been someplace else in another city, you see Stu Barnes beating somebody high. Good puck control, good shot in front that was blocked by Adam Foote. There's the confusion. You know what? It doesn't just pop out. Dave Lowry deserves a tremendous amount of credit. Look, he knew exactly where Stu Barnes was. Patrick Waugh seldom commits first. Not never, seldom. That time he was down on his knees before the shot came, and Barnes beat him high.
We were talking with Darren Pang about Patrick Waugh. Darren noted he doesn't understand why people shoot low on Waugh ever, because Patrick, up high over the shoulders, is the place where ultimately, if there's any room, that's where it's going to be.
Well, what Darren doesn't know is that it's a blur of colors for most forwards out there, and you don't have time to do it. Stu Barnes, and Darren knows that, but Stu Barnes had time there, and that's what's missing.
They've tied the game up 1-1. There was only 1 second left on the power play when he put that home. So a 1-1 game, and they get out of their power play slump in the first one here in this game. Loose at center. Florida wanting to change. They'll send it in deep. The tying goal came at 7:52. Barnes from Lowry and Jovanovski. Young trying to clear it out. Tipped right back in. Panthers had to clear the zone. Barnes gets his sixth of the playoffs this year, answering Forsberg's goal earlier to tie this game up. Johan Garpenlöv moving it in. Sakic tied him up. Chased down in the corner by Lefebvre. Lefebvre dropped it off. Third around near side. Sakic up for Young. Young got it out of the zone, but just barely. And a penalty coming up on the near side boards. It'll be a slashing call coming. Power play when we come back. 1-1.
Now these teams don't seem to hate each other yet. It may be building. That was Brian Schoolin and Mike Ricci. Mike Ricci's been in the middle of so much. And there's Billy Lindsay, who has picked up a penalty for slashing. So the Lanch now get the power play.
8:55, the time of that call on Lindsay. First power play opportunity of the game for Colorado. Colorado's power play in the playoffs this year, just a percentage point better than what they were in the regular season. They were 19.6. In the playoffs, they were 21% the regular season. Right back in and around by Detmarsh. Kaminsky on the far side. Game tied at 1-1. First periods in the playoffs generally have been the Panthers' period. They've outscored the opposition 19-7 in the first period in the playoffs this year, not including the goal they picked up here tonight and the one they've given up. On the near side, Sakic couldn't hold it. Comes back to Ozilic. Sakic tried to knock it down. Terry Kartner gets it up to Fitzgerald, and Fitzgerald clears it out of the zone. Shots are 4-3 in favor of the Avalanche. This one has gone along at a very fast clip. A lot of up and down action, not a lot of scoring chances. The ones that they have had, the two goals have been good ones. Detmeyer sends it back in. Van Biesbroek there. Laws is right there with him, his own teammate. Near side, Forsberg, who has the goal for the Avalanche, holds it in. Kaminsky center in front. Ozilic, great pass. Sakic blocked out deep. Sakic shot deflected into the corner. Two chances for Joe Sakic. Peter Forsberg, great effort to hold it in. What a first period he's having. Couldn't be handled though. Chase at the other end. Huff and Sakic. Sakic got it to Peter Forsberg. Forsberg trying to get up. Both teams trying to change up. Intercepted by Brian Skrudlin. Lost it near side to Ozilic. Ozilic, 40 seconds left on the Avalanche power play. Waits. Teammates coming over the boards. Ozilic moved it in. A little room. Dropped it off. Down low. The shot. Corbet deflected it wide. On the far side. Ricci behind the net. Ricci. Corbet! Shot deflected again. Van Biesbroek may have got a stick on that one. Jammed off the near side boards. Power play still underway here for Colorado. They set it 2 up in front. Sakic's down low as well. Detmarsh looking from on high. Shot. Score!
Scott Young was two of his guys set up in front. See them right there? Both Rene Corbet and Mike Ricci are set up front. There is Paul Laws, number three in red. No stick. As soon as Corbet and Ricci read that, go in front. There's no way he's going to tie both of them up. He can't even tie one of them up. And then the shot looked like it was deflected and over Van Biesbroek's shoulder. Scott Young has got the second best shot on this team with the wrists next to Joe Sakic.
Rene Corbet out in front. Went down, got up, got the stick down, and it's a 2-1 Colorado lead.
He is a goal scorer. Big time junior goal scorer, big time minor league goal scorer, Rene Corbet.
They each team now converting on their first power play chance.
You see what Paul Laws, number three, was up against. Both Ricci and Corbet are there. He doesn't have a stick to do anything. And then there was a partial screen on Van Biesbroek. So give the Avalanche credit on that one.
Brett Warner takes this one back in behind the net. Cleared it out through center. Gusarov giving chase for the icing call here. And he'll get it right there. So we start out here in the first period, only halfway through it. Almost as many goals as we had in the whole of game one. Already a 2-1 game as the offenses coming alive. These have been all three goals good goals.
Yeah, if it keeps going, you know that the Florida Panthers are going to really have to be on top of their game to keep up offensively, because Mark Crawford's guys can really light it up. Sakic, Forsberg, Scott Young, Mike Ricci, Valeri Kaminsky go up and down their lineup. Boy, they've got some powerful offensive forwards.
Forsberg, who picked up his eighth of the playoffs for their first goal. And Corbet getting the go-ahead. Sakic has picked up an assist on that second goal. He and Young getting the assist on the goal by Corbet on the power play. Marner takes it back in behind the net. Right back up by the Panthers and sent in by Barnes. Patrick Waugh cleared it off the boards. Forsberg jammed it back in behind his own net as he had a Panther right on his back. Swung back out through the middle. Shot by Barnes. Deflected behind the net again. Gusarov comes over to get it. Tried to center it. And it'll be cleared out by the Avalanche. Deadmarsh getting chased. Deadmarsh got in. Good play by Gord Murphy. Just dove down and knocked it away. Forsberg hit from behind by Rick Warner. Picked up in front. Foot, long shot, save made Van Beesbrouck. He'll play it himself, had a little trouble with that. Dropped that off and it went behind him, but he got the paddle on it. Kaminsky comes the other way. Kaminsky, Forsberg, Deadmarsh with him. Forsberg waiting, Deadmarsh cutting, not quite. Mellenby tied him up. Deadmarsh in the corner with Mellenby, left off for Straka. Straka up, Niedermeyer out. Niedermeyer tied up, got squeezed in the middle, 2-on-1 the other way. Garpenlob and Mellenby. Garpenlob shot, save by Wah! Rebound deflected into the corner. Net comes off the Marsh peg.
Oh, what a chance for the Panthers. There's Kurt Lisicin. He pinched in the neutral zone, got caught doing it. The 2-on-1. Patrick Waugh was incredible, not only on the original save, but the rebound save. The hits just keep on coming. Here's what happened. There's Kurt Lisicin stepping up in the neutral zone, and away went Johan Garpenlob. Straka with one shot.
Welcome back, everybody. The second game of the Stanley Cup Finals here on ESPN. Gary Thorne, Bill Clement, all of our crew on hand for this one. We'll have intermission reports from each of the locker rooms for you. Patrick Waugh coming up big again in a 2-on-1 opportunity. Those are the kind of saves you remember as the game rolls along, especially when you're in the finals. Mellenby and Uwe Krupp in the corner. Niedermeyer's got it. Niedermeyer trying to wrap it around, couldn't get it there. Straka. Straka comes back to the faceoff dot. Straka sends it on the boards. Goes behind the net. Krupp and Mellenby, new battle. Kicked away by Uwe Krupp to the far side. He gives chase. Straka and he collide. Mellenby over to tip it away for Straka. Straka. Stick picked up on that far side board and finally cleared out of the zone. Young. Young's got Sakic on the left. Young trying to go wide. Kartner won't let him. Good play by Terry Kartner. Just rode Scott Young out of the play on the boards. Adam Foote sends it in wide on Van Beesbrouck. Mellenby and Sakic. Mellenby gets there. Sakic the hit. Puck right up against the boards in the skate. Sakic kicked it out. 3-on-2 the other way. Dropped it back. Foote looking over to Young. Tip. Somebody. Van Beesbrouck. Scott Young with a tip. Van Beesbrouck the save.
Florida got caught in a change. They thought because the puck was in front of their bench, they'd go ahead and got caught.
Take a look at our Miller Beer league leaderboard. Fastest trips to the finals. St. Louis did in a year where all the expansion teams were grouped together. The Florida Panthers really deserve to be one on that list. It's only taken 3 years. Buffalo, Edmonton, and Philadelphia. Quick trips to the Stanley Cup Finals.
Boy, Scott Young is ready to play. Revved up and ready to go. Here's the play coming out of the Florida zone. He got in front of the bench. And see the change? Watch the Florida guys coming on. It was a 2-for-2 change. Oh, boy. Got to make sure. And Colorado was really quick to just to pick the puck out and come in on a 3-on-2.
What a great start to this one. Avalanche leading it by a score of 2-1. Only one penalty's been called here, and it came after the whistle. So a power play opportunity will exist now for Colorado, their second power play chance of the game, as the penalty is going to be picked up by the Panthers' Terry Kartner. We did not hear the call. So Kartner's out of there. Second power play of the game for Colorado. Sakic to Ostalich. Save made by Van Beesbrouck. That came right through the screen by Sandish Ostalich with a great big shot.
You know, Yui Koop this morning talked about the chemistry they have on defense, and it involves Sandis Ozelic. When this team is behind by a goal, the other five defensemen on the bench, they know that Sandis Ozelic is going to get the tap from Mark Crawford, and they go, go get us that goal, Sandis. And Yui Koop said, you know what? When we're ahead by a goal, and it's the five of us playing, and he is sitting there, Sandis says, go ahead, boys, bring it home. See, he's never played in a team where the six defensemen have been this close. It's kind of like an offensive line in football sticking together.
And offensive defensemen, too, when it comes to Ozelic. Sent back in behind the net. Cartner got the roughing call that's created this power play. Came at 12:51, the second power play opportunity of the game here for the Avalanche. And it is a 2-1 Avalanche lead already. Deadmarsh. Deadmarsh drops it back. Near side, Ozelic has got it. Circling at center, Kaminsky. Kaminsky in. Kaminsky waiting. Deadmarsh cutting. So was Forsberg. Goes to Peter Forsberg in the corner. Back up for Kaminsky. Kaminsky looking. Near side sacking. He was open on the weak wing, but a hard pass to handle. Deflected in the corner. Good play by Ozelic to hold it in. Forsberg comes back up top. They get it set up here. Brought back for Sakic, who's now up high. In the middle, Deadmarsh setting the screen. Near side, Forsberg shot and score! Oh, is he red hot?
That's a power play. Talk about puck movement. For a while there wasn't any and nothing was going to happen, and then the Avalanche started moving it. You know, it almost looked like Peter Forsberg took too much time, but when he was able to get the shot by Rhett Warner's shin pads, there was nothing Van Beesbrugge could do. He was screened, and it was a point blank laser from Peter Forsberg, and it is a 2-1 hockey game. 3-1 hockey game. Make that. In front of the net, what you want to do is make sure that the penalty killers are not able to spread out and take the people to the side. When the Avalanche have two people in front, Rhett Warner, 23, had to delay, and then he moved out to Peter Forsberg, couldn't get there in time. I think Doug McLean's still upset at the penalty call to Terry Gartner. We never saw it. Still don't know what it was.
Peter Forsberg, a 30-goal scorer during the regular season, one of the highly rated offensive players in the National Hockey League, has come out here tonight playing like a house of fire.
No, the one thing that Florida really had to hope would happen is that Peter Forsberg would continue to be frustrated and to struggle offensively, because it's the last thing the Panthers needed to have happen here.
It is now a 3-1 game. The Avalanche is 2-for-2 on power play chances in the first period. Lewandowski gets chased into the corner. Got hit by Keane, dropped it off for Laws. They have scored their 3 goals on 9 shots. The Panthers have a goal on 6 shots so far. Sent in by the Panthers, wide on Patrick Waugh. Lindsay giving chase, dropped it off. Garpenlup. Garpenlup goes to the corner. Garpenlup with John Klemm working on him in the corner. Takes him down. Puck freed up behind the net near side. Yui Krupp came over to play. Krupp starts it out. Yui Krupp leading a charge. Krupp led all shooters in game 1. Hello, Yui, and welcome back. Deflected into the corner. Lewandowski put the big hit on, and he does it again. Some rattling going on there in the corner. He and Rene Corbeil, they're still battling in front of the net. Now Van Beesbrugge hits Corbeil and takes him down. And a penalty coming. And I think it's on Van Beesbrugge.
This is the time of a series where the discipline really has to be controlling your emotions. It really does. The Florida Panthers have come this far. They've really got to play smart hockey now. They're down 3-1, and they're going to have to kill a penalty. But Randy Corbeil had the face wipe from Eddie Joe. Then they went in front. There was a little stick hold. But when he ran around the side, and it wasn't much, but John Van Beesbrugge did get the stick and the blocker out in front of Randy Corbeil as he was trying to go around the net. Corbeil played it straight. John Van Beesbrugge didn't do much, but it was enough. And I think if Eddie Joe had held the stick and face-washed Corbeil, Koharski might not have called that.
Let's check in with our man downstairs, our own goaltender, Darren Pang.
You know, we may be seeing signs of fatigue, fellas, for John Van Beesbrouck. He has admitted as such during the course of this entire playoffs. He's not a big guy, but he's got tremendous stamina and obviously a great deal of pride. The one thing, fellas, that we've talked about a lot, players crashing the crease. John Van Beesbrouck is just veering him off to the corner. And it looks right now like, again, it's us against the world for the Florida Panthers.
Well, they are not a team noted, of course, for their offense, but for their defense. John Van Beesbrouck, obviously very unhappy with himself and what's happened here in the first period.
Yeah, no question about it. Doug McLean and his team really have to stabilize now. 3-1, big deal. They got two periods left. Now it's difficult for Florida to play catch-up hockey because they play catch-up hockey based on forcing turnovers when the other team is making an offensive rush. And when you're an offensive team like Colorado with the lead, you don't have to take chances. That's why it's hard for the Panthers to generate offense. They're trying to calm things down, Aaron. They call the timeout, Gary?
Yes, they have used their only 30-second timeout here with 5:10 to go in the first period. So obviously this is a settling down moment. They've got to try and do it here in the rumble, though, of this Avalanche crowd. A 3-1 lead and another power play coming. The man who won the MVP, the Conn Smythe, in the playoffs last year. Of course, Claude Lemieux sitting out his second game. This Stanley Cup memory brought to you by Dodge. And it was Claude Lemieux with the New Jersey Devils last season. Playing a magnificent game, the usual kind of stuff, but also this, the scoring that they did not expect to get from a Claude Lemieux to the degree they did. Our Dodge Stanley Cup flashback. Well, big power play right here. A 3-1 game.
Huge.
They've already gone 2-for-2 in the power play. The interference on Van Beesbrouck at 14:43 was the call. And here they go in the power play. Can they go 3-for-3 on it? Detmeyer in the corner. Tied up over there. Carter put a hit on. Sackick the shot. Deflected wide by Forsberg.
What you're going to see, and I know we're going to get a good look at it. Peter Forsberg just scored an incredible goal. There is nothing John Van Beesbrouck could do about this one, and if you didn't see it when it happened, you'll know what I'm talking about when you see it on the replay. John Van Beesbrouck had a monster happen behind him. It came off the boards and came out by his shoulder, and there was absolutely nothing he could do. We'll start it off with Gordon Murphy here trying to check in the corner, and he ended up losing his stick on the play. So without his stick, he ended up picking it up, but that was too late. Adam Detmarsh and Joe Sakic, watch this, off the glass, now watch it, on the top of the net, to the front, and then a smash line drive by Peter Forsberg into the top right corner of the net. That is amazing. Joe Sakic shot, a great save by Van Beesbrouck, but then the monster came off the boards, off the glass, and Peter Forsberg got an absolute legal goal. The rule is the stick can't come into contact with the puck higher than the crossbar. That was obviously lower than the crossbar. What a goal.
What a game. How many is he going to have? 4:55 left to go in the first period. He's already scored a pure hat trick and a 4-1 lead. Now the captain, Brian Strudlin, elected by the players to be their captain, going up and down the bench that this thing isn't over. 4-1 Colorado lead.
But they're in a hole. Look at the glass behind. Brand new last game of the season, no seams. Van Beesbrouck with the save off the glass from behind. Now John Van Beesbrouck doesn't know where it is. He picks it up, I think, right over there. See, he saw it, and it looked like it was going to come down in his glove. He waited for it to come down. It never got there.
Believe that. How many times will you see that one repeated on a replay? Bouncing off the net and batted in at waist level. What a goal. That is the 7th hat trick of the playoffs this year. Joe Sakic has one for Colorado. Forsberg now adds his name to that group. in the first period. Sakic waiting, shot off the end of the stick on Van Beesbrouck. Mellenby over to get it. Cleared back through center. Panthers want to get one back here. Offside. Niedermeyer brought it in, but a winger ahead on the right. Forsberg picking up the goal at 15:05. He's got three here in the first period, and it is a 4-1 Colorado lead.
Welcome back to Denver. Well, the Colorado Avalanche are on fire. Peter Forsberg and everybody else has been just outstanding. Forsberg is taking it to the net. He's knocking pucks out of the air. Colorado set out what they wanted to do. Be aggressive, be assertive offensively. They've certainly done it, guys.
Well, I tell you, they've got a 4-1 lead here. Four goals and 11 shots in this first period. Forsberg has got the hat trick. Corbet has got the other goal. Sakic has picked up three assists in this period as well. So it's still just two games in the playoffs that he's been held scoreless here in the first period. He's made up for the last game where he did not have a point. Now the Panthers have got to dig right down to the soles of their feet to find a way to get back into game two.
It's incredible that Joe Sakic has only held pointless in consecutive games three times during the season. But you see the Florida Panthers, four goals allowed this period. That is the most by any team against them in one period in the playoffs.
Panthers averaging just 2.4 goals against them in the whole playoffs. 2.4. And they've already given up almost double that here with four in the first period. 3:48 left to go in period number one. Faceoff coming to the left of Patrick Roy.
You know that Stu Barnes and Ray Sheppard are going to get tons of ice time now. Doug McLean has no choice but to really try to work his two offensive lines out there as much as possible.
And a save made by Roy. The shot from the point. Lewandowski had the opportunity. Laws on the near side trying to hold it in by Hammond. Did once. Taken back though by Adam Foote. Detmars coming the other way. Detmars moving it in. Lewandowski reached around him. Detmars plays it off the dasher. Paid for it. Took the hit from Jovo. Dumped right back in behind the net to Detmars. Lewandowski, and he is still doing battle back there. Coming back to help out was Hammond. Dave Hammond. In the corner, jams it up against the boards, and they'll get a whistle here for a faceoff. Want to remind you, the Stanley Cup coverage will be continuing Saturday as Fox will have game three from Miami. Florida will be hosting at Colorado. And Monday, right back here on ESPN, our quest for the Cup starts at 7:30. And at 8 o'clock game time, we'll have it for you on Monday. The Avalanche and the Panthers game four. Want to thank Mike Emmerich and J.D. John Davidson for their kind plug during the last game on the Fox and our return to them.
Yep. Way to warm up the series for us, guys. Peter Forsberg, you know, is going to be a target. That's Dave Lowry hitting him. You know the Panthers have to continue to do some of the things they do best. That is take the body, grind in your face, forechecking. It is 4-1. That doesn't mean they should fall apart and get away from their game right now.
And nothing personal, J.D., but we hope it ends in 4, 5, or 6. Because Fox has game seven. At center, knocked away to Carter. Carter going back to the blue line with it. A 4-1 lead here for the Avalanche in the first period. Lindsay trying to tip it ahead. Yui Krupp got a piece of that. Shipped back out by Lefebvre on the high flip. Carter going to get it in the corner. Gary Carter up the boards. Clem intercepted. His shot deflected wide. Garpenlove on the far side. Johan Garpenlove starts it out. Florida trying to find a way. The Avalanche making sure their D are back here. On the near side, Yui Krupp. Krupp, just 6 regular season games with that crippling knee injury in game one of the regular season, has made an enormous difference getting back here for the playoffs. Lindsay wide on Patrick Roy. Niedermeyer over to get it in the corner second. Allenby moved up on him. Yui Krupp on the near side. Krupp just flipped that one out the center again. Brett Warner there. Warner got tied up on the boards. They almost be as important here for Colorado to prevent the Panthers from scoring as it is for them to get another goal here in this period. They don't want the Panthers to go to the dressing room with any kind of good feeling about this period. Back up along the board, sent out by Young. And we are down just a minute 50 left to go here in the first. Martin Straka. Straka moving it in. Dumped it. Gets it back from Mellenby. Straka. Niedermeyer set up in front, so is Mellenby. Straka can't get it out there, though. Still has it. Great puck control. Sends it back. Mellenby. He's looking out in front. Scott Mellenby has to go back on top. Lost the shot wide. Rebound. Jovanovski has joined the play. The defenseman was right down at the side of the net that time, and nobody was covering back. Laws is the only one there. Ricci's on the left. in, in shot, and it was missed wide by Ricci. It ended up in a 2-on-1. Nobody covered for Jovo, who went down low.
And Jovo has the green light. Eddie Jovanovski, Doug McClain told me before the game, he said, look, we got to generate offense against these guys. I want our people to pinch in, take a few chances. But yes, somebody has to cover. Scott Mellaby was there for a while. Then he got sucked into the offensive end, too.
2-on-1 chance. 1 minute left to go here in the period. Patrick Waugh. Waugh plays it off the near side board. Mike Huff was there to hold it in. Chip back behind the net. Strudlin. Strudlin. Ewing Krupp. Collide. Strudlin. Centered for Hall. Tied up. Sylvain Lefebvre dug it out. And it's cleared out by Kaminsky. Chased down at the far end. Robert Svala. 38 to go here in the period. And right back out. Avalanche just want to keep it out of that zone now. Intercepted again by Huff. Centered in for Strudlin. Strudlin hit. Centering pass. Strudlin intercepted. No penalty call as Forsberg got dumped. All the shots. Strudlin tipped. Where'd the puck go? To the far side boards. All the way out the center. Lowry's got to come back to get it. 16 left to go. Brett Warner sends it in. Shots are 11-8 in favor of the Avalanche. Shot in wide on Patrick Waugh. No tip out in front. Jumped off the near side. Shot by Shepherd. That deflected. Warner shot. Deflected by Keane. Gusarov over to get it. You're going to get a big cheer here in Denver, Colorado. Peter Forsberg with a pure hat trick. 3 goals in the first period. Corbet had the other. Barnes the only goal for the Panthers. And for John Van Beesbrouck, a long first period. But the goals that were scored were scorers' goals.
Absolutely. I'm not sure he could have done much on any of the goals.
So the Avalanche have the first period they wanted. When we come back live from the McNichols Arena, John, Barry, Darren, Brian will be joining you right after this.
John Van Beesbrouck between period during the course of the first period, he takes him out at the end of one period. Mark Fitzpatrick gets the nod for period number two.
Well, what a huge change. There is the backup now in the net goaltender, the 27-year-old Mark Fitzpatrick. You see the numbers that he has had during the season. Played 20 minutes in that series against Boston. He's on now.
And what he has to hope is that Peter Forsberg has his offense out of his system. Because in the first period, he was a one-man wrecking crew for the Colorado Avalanche, scoring a natural hat trick. He got 3 in the first period on John Van Beesbrouck. That'll tire a goaltender out physically and mentally. So that's why Mark Fitzpatrick is in there. Forsberg scored the first one short side, a little tip in to Van Beesbrouck's right. His second goal, power play, short side left. What do you call his third goal? Short side from the top. We'll call it from the top. He did it all different ways with the big shot, with his hand-eye coordination, with that line drive into the top of the net, and with a great one-hand move to score the first one.
So John Van Beesbrouck, the veteran, the last thing he wanted to happen in this game was what's happened to him in this first period. The last time that he was replaced was during the regular season. Came back on March 2nd when he was relieved by Fitzpatrick. Doug McClain making the move here, obviously trying to generate some firepower out there in front of Mark Fitzpatrick. We go to the second period. What also is going to be remembered in the second period belongs to the Avalanche, both during the regular season and here in the playoffs. This is where they have had their best luck in outscoring the opposition. Shot in, and Fitzpatrick gets welcomed in a hurry as he hauls that one down on the high shot.
The one thing that's impressed me about Mark Crawford's team in the playoffs, they are far better defensively and can play far better defense than I thought they could. So that's what Florida's up against. Here's a sequence at the end of the first period where you got good man-to-man coverage by the Avalanche, good man-to-man coverage there. Watch, Adam Foote actually goes in front of the net. Number 52, White, loses his man, comes around the net, picks him up again, and then you've got Velcro man-to-man. 1, 2, 3 examples of it. And even if the coverage breaks down, there were 2 other guys that came back in at the end of that sequence. There were 5 Avalanche players all back in deep.
On the shot, Fitzpatrick, a big save. Kick shot by Sakic. Sakic deflected off the D. Fitzpatrick going, so this is what it looks like out here.
How do you like it?
Sent back in by Straka. Welcome to the game. Ricci. Mike Ricci starts it out. Ricci sends it in behind the net on Fitzpatrick. Near side, Sakic couldn't knock it down. Scott Mellenby drops it into the middle. Niedermeyer coming. Niedermeyer over to Mellenby. Mellenby the shot. Patrick Roy wasn't headed to the net. He gloves it in any event. It hangs on. Usarov, Mellenby.
Gary, did you see how Patrick Roy actually stuck the hand out after? I mean, it almost was kind of mocking the Panthers. I don't know if that was his intention, but when he caught it, he sort of dished it right up front, saying, "You want it, guys? Here it is." Now, I don't know if that's what he was thinking. Boy, it sure looked funny. Scott Mellenby picked up a pass from Niedermeyer. Rob Niedermeyer crossed to the blue line, and Mellenby just got the shot. There's the save. It's sitting there. Here it is, guys. He dished it out in front and actually held it out front and said, "Anybody want it?"
Part of the strut is back in Patrick Roy's game.
Ain't that the truth?
He's feeling very good about the way he's playing, and legitimately so. Set back into the corner, foot around the boards. Forsberg, who already has the hat trick in the first period. Nobody in the franchise history of this Quebec Colorado team has ever had more than 4 goals in a playoff game. Forsberg certainly has got a shot at it here. This guy's loving what's going on in front of him right now. Only 8 shots against him put on by the Panthers.
Panthers can shoot high on him all they want now. He's got a 3-goal cushion.
4-1 lead. Shots are 18-8 in the game. There are the numbers on Wah, the Quebec City native, coming over in that huge deal, which may ultimately be spelled CUP when this thing is all said and done, when that trade is defined. Shot deflected on wide to the near side boards. Lowry giving chase. A long way to go here in game 2. The Panthers didn't get here by curdling up and disappearing in games. Back into the middle. Right in, intercepted at center ice by Murphy. Cleared back up along the blue line and out into the middle. Barnes giving chase. Foot got there first. Shepard held it in, lost it. Peter Forsberg off Shepard's stick to center to Kaminsky. Kaminsky looking back into the middle. Forsberg brings it in left side. Forsberg, Adam Foote the trailer, the D goes behind him. Forsberg turns, got open, sent it on the wide side, couldn't be kicked in front by Kaminsky. Intended for Shepard. Forsberg's playing everywhere.
Look at that. He got back to cut the pass.
Forsberg goes to front. Kaminsky looking for him. Centering pass blocked into the corner by Gord Murphy. You are seeing this Colorado Avalanche team at their best here thus far in this game. I mean, they are flying, and Forsberg flying as well as any of them right now as he headed to the bench in the line change. Yell trying to kick it in. The rookie lost it, tried to block the pass, couldn't. Decision stepped up, but it was outside the zone. Take a look at our Bud Ice Stanley Cup summary as we are now in the final series. First Stanley Cup final with the teams in it involved each for the first time. It last happened in 1914. No team has won the Stanley Cup in their first playoff year. Could happen this year for the Panthers. No team has won the Stanley Cup. The 1914 teams in the Toronto Blue Shirts. Think they didn't sweat in those babies? Solid wool.
Yeah, but they were playing in March when it was still sub-zero weather in Montreal and Toronto in those that time of the century.
And playing outdoors.
Yeah.
Sent back in by Lecision around the far side. The Panthers looking for the out here. Will dump it back off the boards. Laws hit by Sakic. Held in Lecision. Save made Fitzpatrick. And there'll be no rebound. Fitzpatrick in his 8th season, 3rd year with Florida, career 90 wins, 86 losses, and 31 ties. From the Islanders to the Kings, back to the Islanders, and now with Florida.
And it's a good move. You know that John Van Beesbrook at least needs a mental break. I mean, when they're coming at you the way Colorado is really coming at the Florida Panthers in this hockey game, physical rest, mental rest. Doug McClain knows that if he's going to win the Stanley Cup, it will be on the strength of John Van Beesbrook's play. He needs him for game 3. And he may even put him back in here. This is not a done deal that Fitzpatrick will stay the entire game, depending on what happens.
Yep. Novodosky cleared it around fireside. Hop, hop, dropped it in the middle of Hull. Hull reaching back, crisscrosses with Struble. Hull, the chance deflected. Patrick Waugh plays it after Lefebvre had blocked it. Law is able to hold it in wide side. Panthers changing. Lindsay just on. Lost that one to Ozolin. Sends it out onside. Breaking in Warren Reichel. Reichel! Side Fitzpatrick! Ended up in a 2-on-0 chance that time at center ice. Lefebvre the other way. Novodosky will give chase. Big opportunity. Fitzpatrick comes up for the save. And Florida Let's see if they can help their netminders at the other end. Fitzgerald. Fitzgerald moves into the corner. Lefebvre on it. Fitzgerald dropped it off, centered in the middle. Warren Reichel was there to cover. Brought back up by Yell off the far side boards. Keane took the hit from Partner. Cleared around near side for Svela. Svela looking for a little help. Avalanche were changing behind the play. Fitzgerald moving it in. Puck checked away to center. Panthers have to get onside. They did not as Garfin Love moved in. Great to have you with us here in Denver, McNichols Arena, where the home Avalanche have a 4-1 lead out here in the beautiful landscape of the Rockies. Avalanche trying to get their names on the cup after finishing second during the regular season overall in the NHL. They had the second best offense and they've shown why in this game. Jumping out to that 4-1 lead, trying to take a 2-0 lead in the series. Sent in by Martin Straka, giving chase. Waugh got there first on the near side towards Mellenby to hold it in. Straka. Straka, Mellenby, and Niedermeyer. Centered. Goes all the way through. Picked up by Young on the far side. Sakic and Ricci both cutting. Intended up ice for Ricci. Who's back into the corner. Svela comes back to get it. The two governors, as usual in the Stanley Cup Finals, governors of the states make a bet. In this one, it's a bushel of oranges from Lawton Childs in Florida. And a package of buffalo steaks to go the other way.
Like them both. Well, Florida's gambling. Here's the puck. Ozilinch is going to go and get the puck. And in a second, I'll show you what Florida is doing to try to gamble. Ozilinch with the puck now over on the side. He'll dump it up the middle. And we'll stop right there for a second. Both Eddie Jovanovski and Paul Laws, the defenseman, allow these two men, Joe Sakic and Warren Reichel, to get in behind them. I mean, you can stand it in the blue line a little bit. But you just can't stand there without honoring a couple of guys like Sakic and Reichel behind you, especially Joe Sakic. Warren Reichel's not the scorer of the two, but boy, you can't gamble like that just yet.
See, the odd man rushes. Avalanche have the 3-1 edge in that one. In game one, Florida had only one odd man rush, while Colorado had four. Neither team converted in game one on odd man rushes. Corbet for his second goal.
Fitzpatrick that has just gotten tougher. Doug McLean's guys now trail 5-1. A real stoppable short side high shot. But in Mark Fitzpatrick's defense, his first action of the playoffs, he comes in cold in relief of John Van Beesbrouck. But even there, that bank pass off the boards went right to Rennie Corbet. That's a short side shot that has to be stopped high to the blocker side. And the Avalanche have a 5-1 lead. I mean, Gord Murphy needed support there, and that is unlike Florida. Doug McLean prides his team in their desperation backchecking. If they were desperation backchecking there, they would have been back before Rennie Corbet when Gordy Murphy banked it off the boards.
The heads may be down a little bit, and understandably so, down 5-1. And we're only 5 minutes into the second period. Corbet is playing in just his sixth playoff game. He has scored 2 goals in the game. Gusarov in. Empty net. Fitzpatrick down. Shot tipped wide by Deadmarsh. Gusarov center. Shot. Score. Kaminsky. The Avalanche is roaring in every direction.
Game two and rip this baby away from the Florida Panthers. But that is what has happened. We saw a great example of the difference between Mark Fitzpatrick and John Van Beesbrouck. Fitzpatrick far more aggressive. He came out on the original Gusarov rush and was way out of his net. He scrambled back in to get there, but there was a screen set up by Jovanovski. And you talk about shooting high. That's what Valeri Kaminsky did. He saw Fitzpatrick down. He zingered to the top shelf.
He only had two assists in the last seven games. Valeri Kaminsky makes it a 6-1 Colorado lead. It has now become a bit embarrassing for the Florida Panthers.
Sure is. I mean, they're getting their noses rubbed in it right now.
And a long, long way to go. Brought back in Lindsay the shot. Patrick Roy the save. No rebound. Kaminsky, Gusarov, and Detmars the assists at 5:08. Kaminsky's 10th of the playoff year.
When he has daylight, he can make it happen. Here's Gusarov's rush. Look at Mark Fitzpatrick way out of the goal. I mean, John Van Beesbrouck doesn't play that aggressively. Fitzpatrick was able to get back in. Where's the coverage, though? Nobody moved to Gusarov. Both Paul Laws and Eddie Joe stayed in front of the net. And when they decided to take a little move towards Gusarov, Kaminsky was open behind him. You know who's loving this? Claude Lemieux plays with Peter Forsberg and Valeri Kaminsky. That whole line had been in a slump. So here he is watching Peter Forsberg really get on track, and Kaminsky as well. He's going to join him for game three.
Save made by Waugh. Jovanovski the shot. Waugh left the rebound, but nobody there to knock it in. Ozolinch reaching. Reaching guns it into the corner. The Colorado crowd can't help but not just be cheering but buzzing here, because even they find this a little incredible. 6 goals on 17 shots. The Panthers have 1 goal in this game and only 9 shots in the game. Centering pass deflected on Waugh. Jovanovski took a shot at the puck and hit Waugh.
You have to. He is 19, but he knows that when you're down 6-1 and getting embarrassed, you'd better start to assert yourself physically and take some liberties, take some chances, stir the pot a little
bit. Florida has yet to experience a Stanley Cup Finals game. They will be doing that the next two. Here on ESPN, we'll have game four Monday. Our Quest for the Cup show begins at 7:30, and then at 8 o'clock, game four, these two teams going at it. It'll be at the Miami Arena, and we'll be there Monday. Game three will be on Fox on Saturday.
Well, I called this team the team that would bend but not break. That's why I'm very surprised at what I'm seeing. I also thought Florida would play an inspired game based on the fact that they've been trashed in the papers, based on the John Van Beesbrouck stick gate with the knob of his stick being challenged. Tell you what, Colorado Avalanche deserve a ton of credit because they came out and basically beat Florida with a punch. They were a step quicker. Joel Quenneville told Brian Engblom after the first, "The one thing we reinforce with our players, you have to come out at a higher level, more intense level, readier to play than you did in game one." And man, oh man, did they listen.
They have just come out flying. The one thing they present that the Panthers have not seen in the playoffs, even with the teams they've beaten, even with the likes of Pittsburgh, is the consistent speed that comes line after line. We've got a delayed call coming here in the Avalanche. Deflected by Lefebvre in the corner, and there's the whistle. That speed right now of Colorado, line after line after line, Florida just can't match.
Speed, quickness, and when they get the blue line, they let it rip.
Yeah, talent.
Yes.
Scoring talent. They will get a power play here. The Panthers will, on the call coming down in behind the net. As 13:34 remains here in this period, Don Koharski, one of the three officials assigned to the Stanley Cup Finals, Lefebvre goes for the minor.
Finally, a bit of attack off the faceoff. Scott Mellamy got in to help out Rob Niedermeyer. Lefebvre let him go, but by that time it was too late. Scott Niedermeyer, or at least Scott Mellamy, was heading into the boards. So, a place to start for Florida. Power play. And they are down 6-1 after doing something very positive in the first period, scoring a power play goal for the first time in 6 games.
Yeah. Now they need a couple, but take them one at a time. Power play opportunity right here. Comes at the 6:26 mark. Lefebvre the holding. Second power play chance for the Panthers. They converted on their first. Barnes, their one goal, came on the power play in the first period. Near side for Straka. Martin Straka looking. Thela working at the top along the blue line. Jovanovski in the middle for Mellanby. Straka on the far side. Straka. Screen in front. Shot. Thela saved by Waugh. Mellanby at the screen, but Patrick Waugh was there. I want to congratulate the officials who have been assigned to Stanley Cup Finals. Don Koharski working the game. Bill McCrary and Andy Van Helleman are the three referees. chosen to go through the Stanley Cup Finals this season. Knocked away by Patrick Waugh again. We've got the linesman also, Gerard Gauthier, Brian Murphy, Ray Scapinello, along with Kevin Collins, who's working tonight. Congratulations to all of them. That's an honor for them.
It's a long year, and they all want to work the finals, and they don't find out until after the third round of the playoffs. Yep. So they just found out a few days ago. Congratulations to all of them.
Check back in behind the net. Ray Sheppard moving up, deflected a bit, enough to hold it in at the point. Svejla's centering pass, knocked away. Up along the near side boards. Taken off the far side. Power play still underway. Patrick Waugh the save. Lowry in front. Jammed right behind Waugh. Svejla shot. That's deflected wide. Sheppard tipped that last chance that went behind Patrick Waugh. Cleared out by Hannum. Florida cannot draw the break right now. Adam put the high flip. Power play down to 20 seconds.
Great little play by Dave Hannum to dump the puck out of the zone. He switched hands. It was a right-hand slap shot. He's a left-hand shot.
Into the zone. Sakic at his own end here on the penalty killing unit. Sends that one back the other way. Young forcing it deep. Gord Murphy tied up by Scott Young. Deflected, but the power play is over. Panthers do not convert. Huff down the middle, lost it. Puts it back in behind his own net to himself. It was a pretty nifty play. Played it off the boards and got it back. Decision. Team's back at full strength. Terry Kartner. Kartner's wrist shot knocked down in front. Played up again by Foot out of the zone. And an icing call will be coming here on the touch. The Avalanche exploding in this game with a 6-1 lead.
Well, a scoring chance for the Florida Panthers. Ray Sheppard, short side. Patrick Waugh, huge. See, he didn't go down first. He waited for Sheppard to shoot. And then from the short side, Ray Sheppard tried a little stuffer. Patrick Waugh was able to get back and get a piece of it. He'll be a good look at it. Watch him have to scramble back right there with his stick and get just a little piece of it to deflect it out and through the crease instead of behind him. Very quick for a big man.
Teams are at full strength here. Point shot comes right back. Deflected on Waugh wide. Good knockdown in front. Fitzgerald, he got the tip, but it went high and then wide of Patrick Waugh. Garpenlov had Yell moving in on him. Goes back into the zone. The Panthers, 13 shots in the game, trailing here 6-1. At center, Sylvain Lefebvre. Fitzpatrick tried to knock that one down behind the net. Garpenlov moves it out of the zone. Chipped right back in by Stefan Yell with an offside, so Reichel let that one go. We'll now see more of this so-called fourth line. Brought in by Lindsay. Lindsay shot. Waugh the save. Rebound just tipped up to the near side circle. Played out of the zone by Kaminsky. Ricci moves it in. Ricci drops it. Shot Ozilic. Ricci the rebound shot. Goes off the back of the net. Puck tied up. Jovanovski. Ricci doing battle. The puck was free though. So Ricci goes back into the play. And it'll be brought back up by Garpenlov. Garpenlov at center. Knocked away from him by Yui Krupp. Krupp near side. Corbet. He's trying for a hat trick. He's got two. Forsberg's already got a trick. Corbet tied up. Shot off the side of the net that time by Clem. Back in front. And score! John Clem! 7-1.
Everybody's getting into the act, and Mark Fitzpatrick is really under the gun now. John Klemp, a defenseman who hadn't played right wing since he was 8 years old before the playoffs began, has scored a goal, his first of the playoffs, and given the Avalanche a 7-1 lead. That was just a little backhand wraparound, but there was a key there. There was traffic in front. Mike Ricci had set up in his normal place in front with a screen, and John Klemp is on the board now.
7 goals on 20 shots. The Avalanche had a 4-1 lead at the end of the first period. John Van Beesbrouck pulled. We've got 9:50 left to go in the second period.
And when John Klemp gets on the board, he's a defensive specialist. His first career playoff goal. And you know, Ozilic is going to get a chance now to really take off and do some offensive things. All of the Avalanche players now are going to get a chance to do some of the things that they can have fun doing.
Lesation headed into the zone. Sackett tipped it back. Adam Foote trying to hold it in, could not. Avalanche will let it go here and clear the zone. Back up to the near side, Mellenby. Mellenby coming to the red line. Sent in by Martin Straka. A 7-1 lead for the Colorado Avalanche. An explosion that you just don't see in any of the playoffs, much less in the Stanley Cup Finals.
And against Florida.
Yeah. Goal came at 10:03. Clem's first ever in the playoffs with a rookie. Corbet and Krug get the assist. Knocked down by Patrick Waugh. Sent back in for Adam Foote. Spela at the point. Sends it in. Shot deflected. Waugh made one save. Then it goes in behind the net. Centered back in front by Mellenby. Turn around Lowry. Never got the shot off. Lowry battling. Couldn't be held in. His foot knocked it away. Patner bumped it up in the air. Again knocked away at center. Forsberg swung around. Brought in by Barnes, who has the only goal for the Panthers. And back at center loose. Wisserov dumps it off the wide side boards. Sent in behind the net. They were trying to set up Barnes cutting in. Wisserov starts it up the other way again for the Avalanche. Wisserov to Kaminsky. Has to come back and get it himself. In the corner for Detmeyer. Couldn't reach it. Patner. Forsberg. Forsberg with three goals in the game. Ozolinch drops it back in the middle. Setting up Detmeyer. Dropped it wide side. Kaminsky. His centering pass. He is sent out the length of the ice as the Panthers wanted an icing call here to get a line change. They'll get it with 7:49 left to go in the second period. And an Avalanche crowd that can't believe what they're seeing inside McNichols Arena. Gary Thorne, Bill Clement back with you as the Avalanche have, yes, that is correct, a 7-1 lead. 7:49 left here in the second period. Ryan Skrudland, the captain out there, waiting for the faceoff. Skrudland and Sackett. Skrudland won it back in behind the net. Gusarov clears it up. Knocked away at center. Followed in. Ryan Skrudland in the corner. Pinned up behind the net. Huff read it up to Skrudland. Skrudland tied up by Sackett. Huff trying to get a shot off. Hall does. Saved by Waugh. Patrick Waugh. Jody Hall had a chance. Deflected back into the middle on that shot. Annan comes the other way. Annan will flip that one in wide. Robinowski goes back to get it. Avalanche will change it up. In the middle, tipped away from Hull. Played the other way by Lefebvre. Knocked down by Gord Murphy. Murphy sends that one in. 22-16 are the shots. Colorado with the advantage there as well. In the middle, Corbet. Corbet moves it in for the trick. That one deflected off the defenseman, Brett Warren. Held in by Young on the far side. Fitzgerald clears it around the boards and not quite out of the zone yet. Lindsay able to battle it out as he and Ricci were going at it. Brought in by Fitzgerald. Fitzgerald turning, sends it in front. Nobody there. Arkinlove was cutting, but got cut off.
And Mark Crawford, the Avalanche coach, is now able to wheel and deal and trim in a little bit. Got Mike Ricci back at center on this line. Had Sackett out there with Clem before that.
Ricci moving in. Ricci tried to center, but Warren Reichel was hauled down on the far side. Don Kowalski saw it. He's just trying to let the play go on here in the middle of Fitzgerald. Leaves it. Garpinlov shot off the stick of Waugh. Loose in the corner. As long as the players separate themselves here, some of the penalties otherwise that would be called in a close game will be let go here for the moment. But if they don't, then he'll pick them up in a hurry. Knocked away at center again. Straka sends it wide side. Shot on Waugh to save. Straka right behind Patrick Waugh. Second time in this period. Puck's gone behind him and right through the crease.
He didn't have much of an angle, but he did have some room.
Need to hit Patrick Waugh with it. Might have had a chance of getting it in. Huey Krug goes back to get it. Detmeyer. Straka moved up on him. Good pass by Detmeyer. Peter Forsberg has got a hat trick in this game. All coming in the first period. Rene Corbet has got a couple. Detmeyer set up in front. Kaminsky has added a goal in this period. Kaminsky brings it back to the top. Drops it back up. Huey Krug, his shot. Save made. And Fitzpatrick will hang on. ESPN Sunday Night Baseball Game of the Week this Sunday starting at 8 o'clock Eastern Time. you'll see the Oakland A's, Mark McGwire. He has reached base safely in all 36 games he's played this year, 13 home runs as well. The Twins winning 8 of their last 10 with homeboy Paul Molitor, one of the game's great veterans, batting 341 for the Twins. Sunday night, 8 Eastern on ESPN.
What a great crowd this has been here in Denver, supporting their team. Commissioner Gary Bettman, NHL commissioner on hand for this one.
Sylvain Lefebvre unable to hold it in. Late offside call here. Picked up by Sheppard. Sheppard and a save made by Patrick Waugh with Lowry moving in. 17 saves for Waugh now.
Patrick Waugh's sense of who's around him is terrific. He's really in the zone. He's getting the bounces going his way too. I mean, you've got to be hot and good to get them. But Straka wide and Sheppard wide. Something to add to that, Darren Pang?
Hey, fellas, this is a fun time now for Patrick Waugh. I mean, the game's out of hand, and you notice with every save he's making, the more confidence that Patrick Waugh is gaining. I think the Florida Panthers have to be careful with what they fire on Patrick Waugh. Don't just fire from the outside for the sake of putting it on the net, because you don't want Patrick Waugh. He's already got a ton of confidence. You don't want him anymore for game three in Florida.
Yeah, you're right, Darren, about him having fun. And from a forward standpoint, because that's when I played, I can't ever remember in any playoff game having a big enough lead to relax and have fun. I mean, the stress is all of a sudden, poof, it's gone
it's
for
Colorado.
Gone. Now, the only thing is, if you win too easy, sometimes it comes back to get you in the next game because you lose that edge, that fear.
You don't want to let the Panthers back in the game in any way. You don't want to give them something to build on when they go back. Saved by Waugh again, deflected out of foot. Barnes out in front, tip that in on Waugh. That's Barnes going against Sakic over there. Sheppard back up on top toward Murphy's shot. Deflected wide by Lowry. Picked up by Foote, tipped out. No, Young got a piece. Now it comes outside the line. Late offside call here. Panthers clear, though. Sheppard brings it back in. Sometimes it's almost more difficult for the Avalanche to play this game right now than it is for the Panthers.
Oh, you can develop bad habits, that's for sure.
Yep.
You can.
You just lose your focus and concentration with a 7-1 lead.
And that's what I was talking about. If it carries over to game three, then Florida has an early advantage right away. And I've seen it happen, too.
Krug goes back to get it. Around the near side to Corbet. Nick Corbet dropped it to center. Lodge sends it right back in off the dasher and around the boards. Fireside Huff trying to center. Had it deflected to the point. Shot there in front. Cleared to the near side by Lefebvre. And out of the zone, Corbet to Hannah. And he'll ship that one down the boards. In behind the net, Brett Warner. Warner with John Clem on him. Clem has picked up a goal here in this period. Pass into the middle. Huff dropped it off. Powell. Powell trying to move it back out. Florida not a lot of skating room as Ozilic put the hit on there. Lefebvre clears it around. Corbet, Kaminsky, and Clem. The goals here in the second period after Forsberg got three and Corbet got one in the first. Stu Barnes has the only goal in this game for the Florida Panthers. Down the boards. Yell centered in again. Partner going back to get it. Near side for Garpenlund. Garpenlund's pass a little too wide. Ozilic coming back to get it. Down to 3:15 to go here in this second period. I want to remind the people in Florida, the Stanley Cup and all of the other great NHL trophies is going to be there for you to see starting at 9 o'clock Thursday morning, 24 hours a day. Fitzgerald poked away by decision. It's at the Sheraton Ball Harbor. Sheraton Ball Harbor is where they'll have all the paraphernalia, the NHL, from 9 a.m. Thursday through Game 3 Saturday. This is an amusement park not very far from McNichols Arena, Ilitch Gardens. Lots of entertainment and a very famous ride called the Avalanche.
I love those rides that make you go upside down and then throw up. I think this looks like one of them.
There you see the roller coaster there that's in that park next door. Inside, it's been a roller coaster for the Panthers here tonight. And a power play coming up here as Warren Reichel got called on the roughing at 17:01. Third power play opportunity of the game for the Panthers. They scored their only goal in the first chance in the first period. Forsberg scored first at 4:11. Then Barnes tied it up at 7:52. From there, it's been downhill. Jovanovski's shot deflected in the corner. Adam Foote and Niedermeyer do battle over there. Mellenby came over to help. Couldn't get the puck. Sent up by Yell. on the penalty killing unit. We have 2:41 left to go here in the second period at McNichols Arena in Denver, where a very excited crowd kind of sitting back now and just taking a look. Big shot put on by Keane. Murphy moves it back in. Jordan Murphy on the power play for the Panthers. Patrick Waugh tipped away on the far side. Niedermeyer up for Murphy again. Murphy behind the net. Straka waiting. Straka. Mellenby sets up in front of the power play. Straka goes back to Murphy. Murphy over. Jovanovski on the near side. Murphy. Avalanche come out. Put the heat on here. Huey Krupp in the corner. Mellenby. Niedermeyer moves over. Niedermeyer comes away with the puck. Jovanovski up high. Fakes. Doesn't take it. Minute left in the advantage. Bad pass by Murphy, and he knew it. Intercepted by Krupp. As soon as he sent that in, his head went down. He knew he'd made a mistake. Dumped in the corner. Gordon Murphy, a veteran who, when you do one of those, you know right away. You just put the head down and backed up the play D.
It's a sure sign things are going bad for Florida when Gordon Murphy makes a mental mistake. One of the sharpest players that plays out there. He has to play not that strong physically, but boy, oh boy, he gets the job done with his smarts.
Yep. Just forgot where he was looking on that one. Side of the net, Sylvain Lefebvre. Lefebvre around on the near side, not out. Svela drops it off the boards, intended for Barnes. Lefebvre got there. Svela shot right on Waugh, chest high. 20 seconds left on the power play for the Panthers. Our Visa storyline here tonight. Rene Corvey has picked up a couple of goals and an assist in this game. First of the playoffs for him. Sakic, 3 assists. Ties the NHL playoff record in the first period to get all 3, and the hat trick for Peter Forsberg.
You know, the hitting has died down, so when it comes by surprise, you got to brace yourself. Mike Keane kind of snuck up on Ed Jovanovski, but because of the difference in size, Keane went down. That's how solid Eddie Joe is. He didn't even see Mike Keane coming, then he gave him a YIATA right in the back of the head.
Power play still underway here. Lefebvre in the penalty killing unit for the Avalanche. Knocked back into the corner by Young, who sends it around the near side. Not out. Svela steps up again. Behind the net. They're looking out in front. Try and find Lowry. Go back to the point instead. Partner. Power play is over. So 1-for-3 on the power play for the Panthers. And it's still a 7-1 lead here for Colorado. Svela back at Reichel charging at him. Reichel just out of the box. Lowry moves it in. Lowry pinned up, double team. Sakic was there. Cleared up by Lefebvre. Hits Svela in the face. Turns around, keeps playing. Ended up ice for Sakic. Would have had a 2-on-1, but Carter was there to knock it away. Colorado's penalty killing unit during the regular season, 84%, 85% effective during the playoffs this year. Both teams making changes on the fly here. Our shots at 23-22 in favor of the Avalanche. Ripped wide by Huff. Hull back for Huff behind the net. Strudlin in front. Couldn't get the shot off. Ozemlich tied him up initially. Sent back in on Waugh. Strudlin centered again. Blocked that time by Forsberg. Forsberg's played a pretty strong defensive game when he's needed to here as well.
Sure has. He just took an elbow on the yap too. And Don Kowalski, I think, it glanced away just when it happened.
Not coming behind the play after Forsberg got it out. And that's the end of the second period. What do you do? The Panthers find themselves trailing 7-1. Going to the third period, the Avalanche won game 1. Mark Crawford's team with a chance to go up 2-0. The intensity's not dropped for Colorado's coach.
No, the edge is still there. I think he was probably arguing about that hit on Peter Forsberg that wasn't called. Hopefully the Panthers can regroup and at least have a solid period, something they can use as a foundation. This is the play at the end of the period. Mike Huff got the elbow up on Peter Forsberg. Peter Forsberg turned to Don Kowalski and said, "Can't believe you didn't call that."
Forsberg's got the hat trick. Corbet's got 2 goals and an assist. Sakic's got 3 assists. Detmars 2 assists and a period to go. Shots even at 23, but not the score. The Avalanche 7, the Panthers 1. John Barry and company right after this.
I know they've only got 1 period here left, but they're talking about the theme for game 3 in Miami, so they want to set the proper tone. Gary?
Darren, that's it. That's what they're after here, and we're underway in the third period. 23 with the Avalanche with the 7-1 lead, chasing John Van Beesbrouck after the end of the first period when they had a 4-1 lead. Coming on, Mark Fitzpatrick taking his place in net and stays in net to start the third period here for the Panthers. Bisrock turned it out through the middle. Kaminsky going back to get it. Forsberg already has the hat trick. Rene Corbet's got an opportunity to pick one up. He already has 2 goals in the game. And for Forsberg, if he could get another one, it'd be a new franchise mark. First time anyone would have scored 4 goals in a playoff game. Back out into the middle as he came offside. Bisrock came back to get it. Both teams changing. Peter Forsberg turns back into the middle. Reichel the shot. Fitzpatrick to save. Centery pass at the back of the net. Reichel still there. Reichel tried to center while lying down on the ice. Didn't get anything on it. Barnes, a very high flip out to center as the Panthers change up behind the play. Taken back by Young. Young leaves it on the far side. Lucision just sends that one down the boards. Gordon Murphy comes back to get it on the far side for Jody Hull. Hull the scribble. Hit by Reichel. Still had the puck knocked away. Reichel finally comes away with a loose puck.
4 Avalanche players back on that one. I mean, they're not taking anything for granted. There were only 2 Panthers on the attack. They were just surrounded and swarmed.
Near side, Hawk moves it in. Colorado not only playing the fine offensive game here tonight, but defensively getting it done in the playoffs this year. Avalanche have given up just 2.5 a game, while averaging 3.6, which obviously is going to be up as a result of the 7 they already have in this game. At center, knocked away by Huff, lost it. John Clem took it away. Rolled in by Corbet, couldn't play it. Cleared back out. Fitzpatrick got it out to center. Teams again changing it up. Back to get it, Murphy. And Clem moving in. Jovanovski gets it back up. Ozolenc tried to intercept, could not. Dump back in. Straka left it. Straka the tip, never got it. Martin Straka on the near side. Return pass to him just out of his reach. He never got the tip in on net. At the other end, Fitzpatrick plays that up through center. Scott Mellenby just out on the ice, back for Rhett Warner. Warner takes it back in behind the net. Warner off the boards for Straka. Straka's pass intercepted, came right back to him off Yell. Sends it in again, wide side. Gusarov there. Gusarov with Niedermeyer moving up. Kind of slid the pass behind Niedermeyer that time. Back the other way. Keen moves it in. Keen tied up by Mellenby. Puck on the near side. Right at the point. Adam Foot couldn't hold it in. Niedermeyer starts the other way. Niedermeyer. Puck checked away from him. Double team. Gusarov. Good play. Brought back up again by Mike Keen. Keen ridden up by Garpenlove. Got it back. Tied up now by Kochner in the corner. Stefan Yell moved in. Yell. Trying to back it up. Had Svela spinning him around. Battle. Keen. Kochner. Puck sitting against the boards. Control back in the middle. Ewe Koop shot. Fitzpatrick to save. Rebound Kochner. And the Panthers will get it out of there. Garpenlove sends it on the wide side in. Lucision back. Back to the point. Intended for Forsberg. Didn't get it out. And Fitzgerald gets hit in the face. And a penalty coming up. We'll see whether it's going to be a 2 or a 4 here when we get back. There is a double minor here, and it will go against Kaminsky for high sticking at 3:11 of this third period. So the Panthers down 7-1 will get 4 minutes worth of power play time here.
Looking like it was a slap to the jaw. Just watch Tommy Fitzgerald's jaw. The stick is going to come from the right. And luckily for Fitzgerald, I mean, as lucky as you can get when you get whacked in the face with a stick, it hit him flat. So it didn't cut him. Tommy Fitz has had enough cuts in his face this playoff year. He doesn't need any more scar tissue on top of the ones that he already has.
Power play opportunity for 4 minutes here for the Panthers. Gusarov plays it around the net. They've scored 1 power play goal in this game tonight and the previous 3 opportunities. Fitzpatrick working it back in behind the net. Jovanovski came in to pick it up. He'll be working the point on the power play here. Barnes, the only Panther goal, brings it in. Barnes, Lowry goes to the back of the net. He and Adam Foot collide. Sends it back up onto the point here. Good hold in. Shot deflected wide. Barnes was waiting on the near side post. Jovanovski held it into Barnes. Back to the point. Jovanovski and Keane move up on him. Barnes backs it in a little bit deeper. Jovanovski again. Fakes. Got the sliding block there by Keane. Did not come out of the zone though. And Yell has moved out. Tip back to the near side to Barnes. Barnes moving through Adam Foot. Back again up on top. Svela. Jovanovski. Svela. Fela. Near side for Barnes, but deflected off a skate and set up by Keane. Realize how hard it has to be for the Panthers here just to try and keep the energy level up and keep driving.
Avalanche know they've got him on the run. That's why they're being aggressive on their penalty kill. And Florida just doesn't have the confidence right now to move it around and trap him.
Melendez shot went over the head of Patrick Waugh. Back up on top. Fela shot. Waugh to save. Knocked down by Huey Krupp. Good play by Krupp. Waugh made the save. Didn't know where the puck was. It was right to his right. Krupp just reached up and batted it out of the air. Murphy. Power play time remaining. You see a 4-minute power play opportunity sent out of there by Scott Young.
Ooh-wee, baby.
Won't you let me take you on a sea cruise? You remember that song?
Yeah. We won't be able to do that until we get to Miami.
No, we won't. Into the middle, intercepted again. And out of the zone. Gusev able to clear it out of there. Both teams over the boards on the change. Terry Kleiner. Minute 49 now as they're into the second half of the 4-minute power play. Over the stick at center. Kleiner plays it again. Kleiner's dump pass will go to Ray Sheppard, who couldn't get there ahead of Gusev, who clears the length of the ice. Good job of the penalty killers here, keeping themselves up for the Avalanche. Keep knocking it out of the zone. Kleiner comes back the other way. Red line still. Near side Straka to Garpenluck. Garpenluck pinned up along the boards by Huey Krupp. Gunned it around. Nobody at the 5 point. Kleiner moves over into the middle of the ice. Forsberg there to get it. We'll rag it back a little bit. Set back in. Govanowski as it bounces off and in behind that. Fitzpatrick there to hold it up. 106 to go in this 4-minute power play for the Panthers. Govanowski's pass again blocked by Stefan Yell. Svejla. Svejla back around the net. Lost that one. Good play down there by Yell, who blocked that. Yell, the penalty killing unit, still out there. Straka comes through the middle with Hull on the right. Straka tried to get it to Hull, deflected, and Gusev again clears it out. 40 seconds left on the Panther power play. Penalty killers are getting it done right now. Govanowski starts it up ice, goes by Yell. Melendez on the near side, shutting it down, no shot. Govanowski again, running out of time. Svejla shot deflected in front of Waugh, played by Niedermeyer, back up to Svejla. Svejla turning on it. Niedermeyer, Gusev was there. Gusev's been out there almost the full 4 minutes here in the penalty killing unit. Panthers still have time on the power play. Lindsay sets up in front. Melendez near side. Melendez looking. And the power play down to two. Knocked away to the point. Shot Govanowski. Saved by Waugh. Deflected wide. Penalty is over. So they killed off the 4-minute chance. Kaminsky just out of the box, far side. Kaminsky with Govanowski. Kaminsky. Govanowski rides him out of the play and makes sure he stays down. Lindsay comes back to get it. They get into it behind the play. Whoa, who was that?
Who was that?
That'll be an extra penalty. You saw the Avalanche player come flying in.
Is it Kurt Lysishin?
I'm not sure.
Don Kowarski was standing there watching Ed Jovanovski and Valeri Kaminsky kind of exchange punches. He didn't look like he was calling anything, but you knew he would call something eventually. Then Kevin Collins jumped in. That is the linesman that was trying to separate them, and I think it was Curtis Lysishin that came in like he was shot out of a cannon.
The kind of thing you don't expect to see happen in a Stanley Cup Finals game, but when the score is 7-1, it'll happen. Now they're going at it again. They can't get the guys in the penalty box.
But now it's Lysishin and Jovanovski.
We'll get the penalty sorted out here momentarily. Let's check in with Darren Pang.
Thank you very much. We've got one of the great hockey fans here, PGA Tour star Craig Stadler. You're here as well with former fellow PGA player Mark Wiebe as well. You guys have become great fans of the Avalanche.
Yeah, it's pretty good stuff. We got fortunate. We moved here about a year and a half ago and left L.A., which I was a pretty good supporter of the L.A. Kings. Came here where there was nothing. All of a sudden, we got probably this year the best team in hockey.
You know, this jacket that you're wearing right here, it seems to be a lucky jacket. Everybody seems to be bugging you, but when you put this jacket on, and it's a hot building, they score goals, and you got on again tonight.
Well, I ran over Memphis on Tuesday. and up the lot, got in here down 1-0 just about 3 minutes in the second period, and Weeby Stanevries has put the jacket on. She's God, man, I was throwing my butt off and waited about 2 minutes, threw it on, and 3 minutes later we had 3 goals, so I don't know. Just as these guys are, anything goes for him, I think.
Well, thanks, Craig. Appreciate it. Gary Bill.
Graham Stadler taking one for the team.
Yeah, he's really going to sweat in Miami if he thinks he sweats a lot here.
He's used to being out there on the golf course in that sun all day long, so I guess what the heck. Inside wearing a jacket. But the same thing. Power play underway here as the penalties ended up. Colorado got two. Kaminsky and LeCision, both for roughing. Jovanovski got one for Florida for roughing, so the extra went the other way, and the Panthers have the power play opportunity. Want to remind you, Monday night, our coverage of the Stanley Cup Finals here at ESPN will be continuing. The Florida Panthers will be at home for Game 4 against the Avalanche on the road. We will be joining you with our pregame show, The Quest for the Cup, beginning at 7:30 and then the game at 8. That's Game 4 coming up Monday at 7:30 Eastern Time on ESPN. Power play's got 59 seconds left on it for the Panthers, down 7-1, face off in their own zone to the right of Fitzpatrick. Niedermeyer comes out. The interesting brother situations here in the hockey finals, of course, is that last year Scott Niedermeyer won the Stanley Cup with the New Jersey Devils. And here's his brother Rob Niedermeyer with an opportunity to do the same for the Panthers in the very next year. But right now, the hole is going to be a mighty big one. The Panthers are going to have to try and crawl out of, not only in this game, but in the series. Tagner sends it around the dasher near side. Straka. Straka reached behind. Tagner trying to hold it in, couldn't. Flipped out of the zone, near side. Hammond giving chase after he got it out of there. Laws goes back to get it. Laws up for Tagner. 20 seconds remaining on the power play opportunity. They scored on the first power play chance. This is their sixth power play opportunity of the game. Much of it has come after the lead has been piled up by the Avalanche. 4 seconds left on it. Panthers will start from their own end. Power play's over. That one killed off. LeCision is out of the box. And it'll be sent in wide. Could be an icing call. Here it is as Adam Foote comes in on the touch.
Very few positives for the Florida Panthers. But if you look hard enough, you can find a couple. The defense pairing of Terry Kartner and Robert Faila, and there's Terry Kartner. In game one, their team lost 3-1. They were plus one. They were on for the Panther goal. They were on for no goals against. In this game here, believe it or not, it's 7-1. They are losing. They've been on the ice for one power play goal against them. That is it. They are even in this game, plus one in game one. So while their team has been outscored an aggregate total of 10-2 in these first two games, those guys are a plus one.
Almost impossible to do.
That's very, very strong.
John Van Beesbrouck still the netminder of record in this game as he left after a 4-1 deficit after the first period. Fitzpatrick coming on to replace him and has stayed in playing the full second period and here in the third as well. Shots at 25-25, but one of those games where shot totals almost meaningless. And here we go. Jovanovski off the faceoff with Warren Reichel, who went right after him. Fights in the Stanley Cup Finals are almost unheard of.
This is about Eddie Jovanovski taking a liberty with Valeri Kaminsky, at least in the Avalanche's mind. That is what this is about. And this is about saying, you won't get away with that. We don't care if it's game two of the Stanley Cup Finals. We will do something to retaliate.
Reichel will probably get an instigator here. I mean, he jumped right on him as soon as the puck was dropped. He's leaving the arena.
For a guy that looked like he was taken a bit by surprise, Eddie Jovanovski did really well. I mean, you saw Reichel threw his gloves down, and then Eddie Joe was able to grab Reichel by the scruff of the neck and throw him down and then throw a couple of punches. I don't think there was much damage done either way. First part of this season, up to the halfway point, Jovanovski wasn't even allowed to fight because in preseason he broke his hand in a fight. Has a titanium plate in the hand. The first time he was allowed to fight, he broke the titanium plate. He landed a punch so hard. So if you're Warren Reichel, you want to grab on quick and hold on tight.
Jovanovski, one of the youngsters on this very good Florida Panthers team. Not only some veterans that they've done well with this year, but some youngsters to build on. Radek Dvorak's not seen much action here in the playoffs at 19. Jovanovski 19 as well, and Brett Warner only 20 years old.
One of the most underrated players I've seen in the playoffs, Brett Warner, as a 20-year-old, played for three different teams this year. Played, yes, for Colorado. He also played for the Canadian junior national team that went to the World Championships, and played in Greensboro in the American League, and had to learn how to play left defense out of position to even crack the lineup.
He's had himself some kind of a year. Power play as the result of the extra 2-minute minor on the instigating call that went to Reichel. So this is power play number 7 now. The Fighting Majors obviously going to the two of them, Jovanovski and Reichel. Reichel also gets the instigating, the fighting, the game misconduct. So he's gone for the rest of the game. But that's exactly what he thought would happen when he went out on the ice for his last shift.
Did he say, "I'll be seeing you guys later," when he left the bench?
Guys, I'll be waiting. I'll save you a little food, but you better hurry. Lefebvre goes back to get it. 7-1 lead. No scoring here in the third. Forsberg has had the hat trick in this game. He had 2 during the regular season, and he has 2 in his career coming into the game. Now his first playoff hat trick, and he got all 3 goals in the first period. Nate Corbet's had a couple of goals, so he's got a shot at a hat trick as well. Niedermeyer drops it back on top. Gord Murphy's shot deflected wide on Waugh. Huey Krupp deflected that behind the net as he was getting knocked down. Centered. Niedermeyer, 1-2-3, couldn't get it in. Picked up by Hannon, and Hannon will send it up. Niedermeyer, forehand, backhand, forehand.
At some point, the trigger has to be pulled.
Waugh just sat there waiting. 30 seconds left on the power play for the Panthers. He intended for Niedermeyer again. Niedermeyer poke checked away by Adam Foot, sacking out there as well. Foot picks up the loose puck, shorthanded. Rags along the red line and then sends it off the glass. The fans chanting Waugh, Waugh. Contrary to the point after article in Sports Illustrated, all the boys out here do not cheer for Roy. Clear up to the near side to Gartner. Dropped it off for Niedermeyer. Penalty coming up. Delayed call. Looks like it's going to be on the Panthers. Maybe. Not sure. Appeared that way by the whistle. We'll find out. Avalanche leading at 7-1. The big A for the Avalanche, and a lot to cheer for whether you're here or at Jackson's Hole. Well, the Colorado, Denver, Colorado teams so far have put up 19 points tonight. The Rockies are leading Houston 12-1. The Avalanche leading the Panthers 7-1. This is an offensive-minded city. Picked up by Ricci. Dumps it back in behind the net.
You know what? The same is true of the Broncos.
That's right. And Deadmarsh tipping it in. Did. Ricci able to hold it in. On the near side boards, reaching power play underway here for the Avalanche now. Over Ozilinch's head and out the center. Waugh's got the interference call at 11:42 with the action in front of Waugh on the last occasion, giving the power play chance here to the Avalanche.
Paul Laws had been put up front. He was actually playing a forward position. Doug McLean did that near the end of game one. He put Eddie Jovanovski up front at the tail end of the power play. But that wasn't even a power play, and Doug McLean had Paul Laws up front as a forward.
And they go 4-for-4 in the power play. Very effective in this game tonight for the Avalanche, but of course everything has been. Ozilinch's pass off the back of a skate on Skrublin. Sanders Ozilinch. Lefebvre. Puck forcing the play deep there for the Panthers penalty killing unit. Back to center. Lefebvre decides to shoot. Fitzpatrick the save.
That was a surprise shot. Sylvain Lefebvre wound up, and you knew he was going to just drift it hard around into the corner, and he pulled it back and let it rip right on Fitzpatrick. That was a pretty good save because it was a hard surprise shot.
Good low shot. Cleared back up by Huey Krupp. Near side yell. Could not handle that one. Carter cleared it out. Jam up on the near side blue line, taken by Young. Scott Young moving it in. Young the shot. That's deflected off Carter's stick into the seats. 10 seconds remaining on the power play, 6:27 in the third period. On the deuce coming up, the coverage of the National Hockey League draft. It'll be from the Kiel Center in St. Louis on Saturday, June 22nd at 12:30. You'll be able to see it live as the teams make their picks for the future. That'll be on the deuce. And if you don't get the deuce, contact your local cable company and ask them to put it on.
Guy knows something about being number one. First pick overall, 1994 draft.
And that'll be deflected off the front of the Panthers bench. Also on the deuce tonight, 10 minutes after the game, there'll be live coverage of the press conference that's held here. Players, coaches of these two teams. The deuce carries that live 10 minutes after this game has concluded.
Well, nothing has worked for the Panthers. John Van Beesbrouck took a penalty at the 14-minute mark, right around the 14-minute mark of the first period. The Avalanche were coming, so Doug McClain called a timeout to settle things down. Avalanche scored the power play. Nothing has worked. I mean, that looked like it was a pretty decent call at the time. Trying to stabilize. Nothing has worked. Nothing could stop the big white Avalanche from just rolling down the mountainside.
Van Beesbrouck charged with 4 of the 7 goals in that first period. The power play over. Teams back at full strength. Centering pass tipped away. Shepherd tried to get it through. Shot Barnes wide. Picked up by Curtis Lesage, and the Avalanche able to clear it back out. Dumped into the corner. Huey Krupp going back to get it. Both teams making line changes here. Lowry could not hold it in. Kaminsky the other way. He's got a goal tonight. Big shot wide. Wow. Did he wind up on that shot? Valeri Kaminsky. John Daly kind of shot right there.
Well, that is what the Panthers have been faced, is a team that will cross the blue line with speed and let it rip. And as a defenseman, you can't just continue to back off and give them the line. I mean, and you're caught in between. I mean, really, they mix the offense, and it's hard to play against.
Adam Foote takes the shot here, wide on Fitzpatrick. Rebound, Forsberg knocked away by Fitzpatrick, and it's ice snow. Forsberg, the opportunity for his 4th goal right there. Stays out on the ice. Forsberg with partner on him, sending it off the blocker. And off Fitzpatrick's blocker. Hannon on the far side trying to hold it in. Tipped back out the center by Forsberg. Terry Kartner's got it. Avalanche changing behind the play. Scott Mellenby. Mellenby taken down. Adam Foote standing over him and the puck up against the boards. 4:42 to go. Third period. The Avalanche on the verge of taking a 2-0 lead in this series. Peter Forsberg, who came out here an Avalanche onto himself in the first period, getting the hat trick. A very strong total game.
You know, the Philadelphia Flyers raised a lot of eyes when they made him the number 6 pick overall in the 1991 draft. Not many people around here heard of him, and they were hockey scouts and said, you're going to take Forsberg? Flyers knew what they were doing, but he was one of the guys that had to go to Quebec in the big Lindros deal. What a player.
A talent for a long time to come in the National Hockey League. 7-1 lead here for the Avalanche. Teams are at full strength now. 4:16 to go in the third. Garpenlop leads it for Niedermeyer to Garpenlop. They're skating that back to get it. Hannon with a bump on it. Avalanche have not let up here. To their credit, in a tough situation for them to stay focused and stay in the game, they kept skating, they kept hitting. Really haven't changed very much.
How many point blank saves has Patrick Roy had to make since they took the big lead? Hardly any.
Nope.
If any.
If any. Knocks that one away, but a penalty coming up here, a roughing call. Stanley Cup is the champ. Mellenby goes. Our head and shoulders storyline in Denver tonight. Ed Marsh, a couple of assists, has got a 6-game point scoring streak. Sakic, 3 assists tonight, pointless in the first game. Forsberg, the hat trick, now has 10 goals in the playoffs.
All right, head and shoulders replays. How about going back to the first period? We'll take you through the Forsberg goals. One hander to the short side. Giant blast to the other short side, off the post. And then this amazing goal. Over the net, off the glass, back on the top of the net. Bang. Line drive, home run, goal number 3 for Peter Forsberg, and the Avalanche have not looked back since.
3:51 left here in the third period. Power play opportunity again for the Avalanche. power play goals already tonight. This is their fifth power play chance. Mellenbeul's call for roughing at 16:09. Very few shots here in the second half of this game, really. 27-26 in favor of the Avalanche. 9 goals in a Stanley Cup Finals game is the record. We told you set twice. Save made down low. Fitzpatrick shot wide of the net. Rebound. Fitzpatrick jammed it away. Lost his stick. Panthers will be able to clear as Kartner gets it out. Detroit had 9 goals back in 1936 in Toronto and 1942. SportsCenter coming along next. All the day's news in sports for you. In the corner, hit by Laws, whistled on the icing call here.
Gotta like what Mark Crawford's doing. This is his Stanley Cup Finals, letting people like Rene Corbet start on the power play. He was looking for his hat trick goal. Followed up with Mike Keane, John Klemp. Yeah, Joe Sakic's at center, but give these guys, the pluggers, the grinders, the people that have really paid a price without much credit for their effort to get the power play going. Nice little helmet. Speaking of helmets, Mike Ricci's popped off a lot in the playoffs and might have something to do with the haircut. Asked him this morning about haircuts. He said, I've only had one all year. This was his preseason picture. And this is picture before the playoffs started. It's even longer now. We've given Mike Ricci the Shemp Howard Award. If you're into the Three Stooges, you know who Shemp is.
Kind of the reverse before and after. Centering pass by Detmeyer's deflected in front. Sackett! Sackett! Shot! What a save! Mike Fitzpatrick!
Great save. I mean, a tough circumstance for Fitzpatrick to come in this game when he relieved at the start of the second period. The Avalanche don't need any more goals. I'm happy for Mark Fitzpatrick. I mean, that was a terrific save. Sakic had it beat. The seas parted, and Joe Sakic just stepped right through the big opening. Had it beat, except for the glove. Fitzpatrick came down with the glove in the right spot. This is a beautiful save. Watch it from behind him from our goal cam.
This is the 9th playoff game he's ever appeared in. Sakic again, still on the power play. Center, shot, score! Klemm! You'd have told John Klemm he was about to have a 2-goal night. He'd have said, where are you buying him? 8-1.
John Klemp's second goal of the playoffs, his second career playoff goal. And it doesn't matter who has been out there for Colorado. Mark Crawford giving his checkers a chance to see what they can do offensively, and they have come through for him. Joe Sakic will undoubtedly get an assist on this one. That will be assist number 4 for Joe. What a night for him. He continues to inch closer and closer to that Conn Smythe trophy for the MVP. 4-point game for Sakic.
John Klemm had 3 goals in 56 games in the regular season. That's the first 8-goal game in the finals since 91 when the Penguins had an 8-0 win against the then Minnesota North Stars. Lowry banged down in the air. Straka giving chase on the far side. Closing in on the 2-minute mark of this game. An 8-1 lead. Klemm from Sakic at 17:28. First goal of this period. And for Klemm, 2 in his young career in the playoffs, both scored here tonight. Martin Straka over to Lowry. Lowry in. Lowry dropped it right through the legs of Ray Sheppard. Sheppard, the hit on the far side on Rene Corbet, who gets hit by Lowry. Banged away to center. Rene Corbet's out there looking for the hat trick for the youngster. And a whistle on a 2-line pass here. Sports Center's coming right along. John Calipari's made a big announcement about he and the Nets. He's going to go. The NBA Finals Game 2 preview and highlights of the Women's French Open, the semifinals.
You know what I think these fans are thinking right now, Gary, is that this might be their last chance to cheer this team on this season. The way they've dominated in this game, fans might be saying we might not get to see the cup paraded around our own building. They're standing up and giving them the big standing O right now.
Yep. Minute 26 left in the game.
And unless something drastically changes in these two teams quickly, they could be right.
Juan knocked it away. Patrick Juan couldn't stop it. Fitzpatrick tipped it out in front. Barnes may have gotten the last piece. It is the second goal of the game for the Panthers to make it 8-2.
Now, that's how you stop a standing goal right there. What's this? Is not going to count now?
May have been hit with a high stick. They've waved it off for the moment, so hang on. Don Koharski will talk with the linesman.
Let's watch. Tommy Fitzgerald's in front. He's number 21. There comes the shot. Now Fitzgerald definitely knocked it down. Did that look like, it looked like it nicked Stu Barnes on the way to the net anyway? All it had to do was one way. Well, there are two different rules. If it doesn't hit Barnes and it goes right in, then if the stick is higher than the crossbar, it's not a goal.
And the stick was.
Right. If it's higher than the shoulders and it goes to one of your teammates, then it's blown down anyway. So it was clearly higher than the shoulders, so whether it went in or hit Stu Barnes, it was going to be blown down, I believe. Bill Lindsay launched it. Oh, you know what? That was close to shoulder height from that angle. Looked real close to shoulder height.
Well, they've gone upstairs to review it.
So if it's shoulder height and it hits Stu Barnes, even though it was touched above the crossbar, it's my understanding that that would qualify it
as a goal.
As a goal. But it would have to hit Barnes, otherwise it would have been deemed higher than the crossbar if it had gone straight in. It's not going to make much of a difference. It might be a little boost for the Panthers. Here we are. We're at ice level now. Take a look at it. That's below the shoulders. That's below the shoulders, and it looked like it was below the shoulders and above the crossbar. So the question to me was whether or not it went in off of Stu Barnes, who was in front.
That's not reviewable.
No, it is not.
The only thing reviewable is whether or not it went off the high stick.
Right.
So they're reviewing it, and it's not going to count. You think maybe the forum gods, instead of going to the Molson Center, came to Denver?
With Patrick in the suitcase.
Yes. Down to the final minute of game two. Wow, the save. Got a chance at a hat trick. Since 1939, when the series went to seven games, only three teams have come back from a 2-0 start to win the Stanley Cup.
Talk about a team that was in full control of this game, and because of it, now in full control of the series. The Colorado Avalanche look huge, strong, big, and real good right now.
They won the first game 3-1. They have come back in this one to win it 8-1. We'll be back to Denver. The series lead 2-0 Avalanche.